But you walked in with a bag of ice. What was the ice for?
That's for the shin. The shin's pretty bruised up now after kicking him a few too many times.
Overall, being a pretty thorough victory, right? 30-27. I mean, give me 5 after that fight. How did you feel about the performance itself?
Thank you, sir. It feels amazing just to get back. You know, I felt a lot of pressure coming into that fight. Obviously, coming off a loss, you know, it is a lot of pressure because I know the UFC, you know, it's stacked with talent, and you know, you can't take too many losses on the chop because otherwise you're out of a job. So yeah, you know, I was just happy to be back and happy to do what my coaches told me. You know, I wanted to kind of get in there, have a brawl, and you know, I let my emotions kind of get in there with me too much. And they kept saying to me, you know, I kept hearing them say, you know, be a sniper, pick your shots, take him apart. And you know, I like to think that's what I've done. I'd have to watch it back, and you know, they're probably going to give me a bollocking and tell me, you know, what I can do to be better. But you know, I've come out, I've got no injuries from that other than a bruised shin from kicking him. I'm healthy and I've got the win. So, you know, that's what matters.
Yeah. Entertaining. I mean, you guys are having a scrap. I think that's the kind of fight people like to see. But was there any thought at all? Like, hey, maybe we need to switch this up a little bit? I mean, he was having a couple little shots here and there, right?
I felt super confident the whole fight. You know, I felt like I was completely in control. I felt that the only thing I could do to give him a chance is play that 50-50 ball, you know, where it's rock 'em, sock 'em robots. And as I say, you know, coming off a loss, I can't afford to do that. And you know, with there being no crowd, I could hear my cornermen. So I could hear my dad saying, do not brawl with him. And you know, yeah, I had to play it sensible. I had to play it smart. And you know, I'd like to think that's what I've done. And I'd like to think that I still put on a show for you guys.
As you said, you didn't want to take losses. That was important. The circumstances, I mean, obviously everybody's training during a pandemic. Then you get a last second switch up. Did that add challenge for you?
It did and it didn't. You know, I'm always training to better myself, but it did throw me off a little bit, you know, in the mindset as such. But, you know, in this sport, you've got to adapt and overcome. And, you know, I feel like that's what I did. And regardless of the opponent, you know, I turn up the fight. And, you know, whoever the UFC put me in, I get paid to do this. And, you know, whoever turns up on the night is getting it.
That's a great, I guess. What would you like to see next? I mean, now you got a win, you kind of get a little power on your side instead of the other way. So what's the next move?
I'd love a rematch with Dodson. You know, I know he's not going to give that to me anytime soon. But, you know, hopefully I can rack up a couple of wins. And if he doesn't lose in between then, you know, we can get it back on. Knowing his hometown this time, you know, let's meet in the middle. Maybe let's come back here. And, you know, why not? You know, if he wants to get in here and have another scrap, I'd love to do that with him. If not, you know, I've got my eyes on the Cheeto Vera fight and Sean O'Malley. That'll be exciting. And other than that, you know, whoever the Sean Shelby, Mick Maynard, whoever they want to give me, and you know, the UFC want me to fight, you know, I'll never turn down an opponent. But ideally, I would like someone above me. You know, John Castaneda. You know, obviously he took a 3 weeks notice. Ideally, I don't want a debut guy because you know he's not exactly gonna get me up that pedestal. But I'm just happy to be back in it, you know, doing what I love, and you know, I'm rabbiting on a bit here, so that's all.
It looks like the UFC are going to come back here in September, maybe in October. Would you be ready to turn around that quick?
Yeah, for sure. I'm not sure about September, just because I've got quite a few things booked up holiday-wise before then in August, yeah, so that would be probably a little bit too soon, but October sounds good, and I'd love to come back here. You know, the experience here has been amazing, the people here have been amazing, and you know, it's been an absolute pleasure to fight here. So, you know, for sure, I'd like to get back home.
Where are you going on holiday?
Ibiza.
Good stuff.
Hey,
yep.
Okay. People are very obsessed with finishes, but do you see another side of going 3 rounds for the first time in almost 5 years?
It does better your career in the sense of you're getting the rounds in. In an ideal situation, you'd get the knockout in the last 10 seconds of the last round because you're getting that experience in. You know, you're getting you're battle tested. You know, you can come in and get a quick 10-second knockout. It's great. It's great for the camera. It's great for the highlight reels. But in hindsight, you don't necessarily learn anything, but you do learn from getting in the decision. So, you know, ideally, I would have liked to have got a finish, but I'm happy to get some rounds in. You know, it's nice to put a full fight camp in and be able to go out and actually get the lungs going, you know, actually get a good scrap under my belt and, you know, just have fun. And I've got no injuries from it. So, you know, on to the next one.
You mentioned that you want John Dodson fight back. Do you hope to get the Magomedov fight rebooked?
It's definitely something that it's not something I would turn down, but the only thing with that is it would be his UFC debut, and I'm now 4-1 in the UFC, so no disrespect to him. He's one hell of a fighter, and especially being, you know, Khabib's Nurmagomedov's cousin, you know, that's huge for anyone to fight. But ideally, you know, I want to fight someone that's going to put me up on the ladder. John Castaneda obviously took it on 3 weeks' notice. I didn't have a choice. And I could never really turn a guy down coming off a loss. But now I feel that, you know, I'm back on a win. I'd like to get ideally someone ranked above me and start working my way up that ladder again. But if the UFC don't want that and they want me to come in and fight Umar Nurmagomedov, however you say it, I think I said it right, then so be it.